Ali, in our conversation at SOCAP, you made a really great point where you said, even though we say we don't need to replicate Silicon Valley, it still feels like we're trying to do that. So I wonder if you can expand on that point and let us know, why does that not work, trying to replicate Silicon Valley, and what are the alternatives?
Sure. Well, first I'd say market agnostic, if anyone's been following the headlines from what were sort of darlings of the Silicon Valley model, like WeWork and some others who have either had struggles or postponed IPOs, even Silicon Valley is starting to question the Silicon Valley model and have a sort of movement back to fundamentals when it comes to supporting early stage businesses and then following them through their growth. So I'd say at a macro level, there's sort of a rethinking of the Silicon Valley model. Sort of diving in a little bit further, I think any market is has its own unique attributes and assets and challenges. And so trying to completely copy and paste one model into a completely different market is extremely challenging. And that's why anybody, including in Africa, I think that is just trying to do a copy and paste has really struggled with trying to replicate the model. When we look at Africa specifically, I mean, there's a unique set of challenges and opportunities in a market where the capital stack looks a lot different than perhaps in a market like the U.S., where there are many more investors that once a company gets started and growing that can sort of come into a company that's getting to sort of a later Series A stage and needs some an injection of capital to continue to grow. That doesn't exist in spades like it does here in the U.S. Where I'm based. And so there's a need to think differently about how we can provide support to businesses and both financial capital, but other types of support as well to help them focus on fundamentals, perhaps become create more self-liquidating structures. So revenue share is a structure that we see gaining increasing traction in emerging markets to say, how could we help companies provide a compelling opportunity for investors that provides liquidity in a market where liquidity may not exist in the ways that they're used to?
That's great. And I actually do want to ask a follow-up question, which we can dive into more deeply a bit later. But when you talk about thinking differently about how to provide support in these markets, that's actually something that Village Capital has done with VillCap Communities Africa. Again, when you and CK and I all talk together in a moment, we can talk more about it. But can you give us a little preview of why that need to think differently led to VillCap Communities Africa and preview of what you did there?
Sure. So the history is we've been operating in Africa as an early stage support organization and investor since about 2014. We've supported roughly 80 entrepreneurs and we've made 16 investments on the continent. And we saw some pretty significant opportunities, but also significant gaps, as I described before, in terms of capital that didn't exist for companies after they got to a certain stage. And then sort of some questions around how we could build a broader pipeline of opportunities, not just for us, but for other investors to come in. We have a fund that is a small fund. We wanted to see a lot more capital come into the market for companies that were starting to come online. And